What's coming in my next section of the God in the Details series, I wanted to cover a sort of go-between set of scripture out of Proverbs chapter 21, because when Elijah has the showdown, and that's really what it is with the prophets of Baal and the ungodliness that's going on there, he actually is at a portion of time and place where he is invoking the judgment of God. He is actually calling upon God to show himself real and strong and powerful to, as he puts it, turn the hearts of the people back towards the Lord God himself. And you know, we are in a generation in which people, if they give any kind of notion to God at all, it is one of really weakness and meekness, not able to carry out or perform the jobs or the functions with which and for which he claims to have power. And yet the Bible is very, very clear that the Lord God himself is a God of wrath, he is a God of judgment, and a God of holiness. And there is a price to pay for ineptitude, for ungodliness, and for sin. And I just keep having to drive that point home, even to and amongst, believe it or not, the people of God, because the world and the church, quote unquote, is so bent on presenting only the God of love and mercy and tenderness. And while he is that, we must remember that God does call into accounting those things that he needs to put right at some point. And Proverbs 21 verse 12 goes in very great and deliberate detail about how he does the house of the wicked and the wicked himself. And I want to read the verse of scripture to you as it's presented in the King James Bible. The King James puts it this way: the righteous man wisely considereth the house of the wicked, but God overthroweth the wicked for their wickedness. You really think about what's in view here. It's not so much that God or that mankind is considering the house of the wicked so much as he is considering the overthrowing of the house of the wicked. Let me give you a literal interpretation or a linear verse breakdown as to Proverbs chapter 21. It goes like this: wisely considers the house, the righteous, God overthrowing, listen to this, of the wicked for their wickedness. See, the emphasis is really to be put on and placed upon God dealing with sin and wickedness as he best and so chooses. He overthrows it. Now, over in Matthew chapter 21, verse 12, now listen to this. Proverbs 21, 12 again puts it, the righteous man wisely considers the house of the wicked, but God overthroweth the wicked for their wickedness. Matthew 21, 12 states it this way, as Jesus is going into the temple after his triumphal entry into Jerusalem. The Bible says, and Jesus went into the temple of God, and cast out all them that sold and bought in the temple, and overthrew the tables of the money changers and the seats of them that sold doves. You think, well, that sure is coincidental. Matthew 21, 12, Proverbs 21, 12. My dear friend, there are no coincidences. There are no accidents in the Bible, the unfolding even down to the letter and the numbers. I'm telling you, God plans things out. This word overthrowing, having to do with in the Hebrew language, to literally to turn upside down, to bring to ruin. It's the Hebrew word salaf, which means to wrench, and that is a sudden or violent twist or pull. Make no mistake, God does and will deal with unrighteousness and unholiness in a dramatic fashion. We saw in the scripture where in Matthew, the Lord Jesus, who is God himself, overthrew, turned over, listen to that, overturned the money changers' tables. It has to do, in the Greek word here, a sudden violent twist or pull. It's literally turning over, turning upside down, just as the Hebrew word back in Proverbs 21:12 stated it. Is God turning things upside down to make that which is wrong right? Make sure you know, God, we're going to see in the book of 1 Kings 18 where Elijah encounters those who are bent for destruction. He's going to make sure that they have their destruction in God's name. And God is going to carry out his great and awesome judgment upon people who will not believe and who reject him. Now look around you, you'll see the day and age we're living in. God's lining folks up. If you'll think about the wickedness and the things that people are so bent on, the destruction literally of humanity and of themselves, all they're doing is lining themselves up just like pieces on a chessboard for the very wrath of God to be unfolded. God will prove himself strong. He does overthrow the house of the wicked and the wicked itself. God bless you. Have a good rest of your day.
Time was always spent dreaming of tomorrow.